गुड मॉर्निंग डियर चिल्ड्रेन, सो होप यू ऑल आर फाइन. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट टुडेज रिकॉर्डेड क्लास. ओके, सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू समथिंग रिलेटेड टू डिवीजन. सो इन द वर्चुअल क्लास टुडे वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन सम क्वेश्चन आंसर्स फ्रॉम द वर्कबुक पार्ट. सो नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विथ अ न्यू पार्ट ऑफ द डिविजिबिलिटी, रूल्स ऑफ डिविजिबिलिटी. सो आवर टॉपिक इज रूल्स ऑफ डिविजिबिलिटी. What is this rules of divisibility? Rules of divisibility means the divisibility. There are some rules of divisibility which are used to test whether a number is divisible by another number or not. So you need to remember the rules. So it's given in page number 66. If you see the book of page number 66, you can see divisibility rules are given there. Okay, so divisibility rules. When do we use the divisibility rules? It's used for testing a number is divisible by another number or not without dividing the number. Okay, we don't have to generally what we do. When we suppose we want to know 22 is divisible by 4 or not. So generally what we do? We divide these two numbers to check whether the number is divisible or not. So if we get a remainder, it's not divisible. And if we don't get a remainder, it's divisible. So instead of dividing, sometimes we may get a bigger number. So in that case, if we start dividing and then testing, it may take time. So to lessen the time and to lessen the burden, there are some rules of divisibility which will help you to know many things, to know whether a number is divisible or not, and it will also help you to go for the other parts of this lesson which is related to factors. Okay, when we will study the factor part, then also we will need the divisibility rules. So you can see page number 66, some rules of divisibility are there. So you mark it in the books. So let me explain you the rules. The first rule is for the divisibility of 2. How will you know that a number is divisible by 2 or not? Okay. So what's written there in the book? The ones digit of the given number must be 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. Ones digit, we know whenever we write a number, it has a ones place. So you need to check the ones place. If the ones place is 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, then that number is divisible by 2. Suppose I write a number 234. I have written 234. So now I want to know whether this number is divisible by 2 or not. So in that case, what can we do? We will check the ones place. Which is in the ones place? The 4 is in the ones place. This 4 is in the ones place. So now what I said you, the ones place number should be 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. So how will you remember these numbers? You think of the multiplication table of 2. In the multiplication of table of 2, we get 2, 4, 6, 8. So in this way also you can remember. And if there is a 0 in the end, then also it is divisible by 2. So since this number is having a 4, so 4 is there. So we can say that 234 will be divisible by 2. Let me take some other number. Let me make it 7 now. So what can we say, the number is divisible by 2 or not? It's not divisible because the number is 7. So we can see no 7 is there. So it's not divisible by 2. Okay. Let me make it 0 now. 230. So how to know the number is divisible by 2 or not? We know that 0 is not there. Zero is there, isn't it? So since zero is there, so it's divisible by 2 again. So whenever you see your ones place is 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8, the whole number is divisible by 2. Without dividing, we can use the divisibility rule to know whether a number is divisible by 2 or not. So this is the first rule for the test of divisibility of 2. Now let us come for the divisibility of 3. How will you know that a number is divisible by 3? Without dividing it. Let us take any number. Suppose let me take the same number, 234 I have written. I want to know whether this number is divisible by 3 or not. So generally what we do, we divide this number by 3 and check whether we get a remainder or not. So here we are not going to use any division, we are just going to use the test of divisibility. Okay. So 234. So you add this, what is the test? You should check your book. The sum of the digits of the given number must be divisible by 3. Sum means we have to add the digits. What are the digits? 2, 3 and 4. So add the digits 2 plus 3 plus 4. After adding the digits, if you see you are getting such a number which is divisible by 3, it comes in the table of 3, the whole number will be divisible by 3. So let us add it. 2 plus 3, 5, 5 plus 4, we get a 9. So our sum is 9. So now 9, we got a 9. So does 9 come in the table of 3? Yes, 9 comes in the table of 3. So this whole number will be divisible by 3. Okay. Let me test with some other number now. Let me take 2, 3, 5. Okay, so I will add these digits now. What are the digits? 2, 3 and 5. Let me add it. 2 plus 3 plus 5. So now I will not get a... Let me see how much I get. 2 plus 3, I get a 5. 5 plus 5, I get a 10. So 10 is not divisible by 3. It doesn't come in the table of 3. So 235 is not divisible by 3. Okay, so always remember to check the divisibility of 3. We have to add the digits. We have to find the sum of the digits. If the sum is divisible by 3, the whole number will be divisible by 3. If the sum is not divisible by 3, the number is not divisible by 3. Okay, so this is the test for 3. Let us come for the next part, divisibility by 4. We want to check the divisibility by 4. So again, see what's written there in the book. The number formed by the last two digits of the given number must be divisible by 4, or both the digits must be 0. So let us write a number. Suppose 1875 I wrote. I have taken this number. Now I want to know whether this number is divisible by 4 or not. So I am not going to divide this number. I will use the test of divisibility. So that according to the test of divisibility of 4, what you have to do is that you have to check the last two digits of the number. So what are the last two digits? The 1's place and the 10's place are the last two digits. So that means 75 is your last two digits. Okay. So now we will check whether 75 is divisible by 4 or not. So what do you think? If you divide 75 with 4, can you divide 75 with 4? Will you get a remainder or you will not get a remainder? Let us check it. So I can see that I am getting a remainder. I am getting a remainder. That means 75 is not divisible by 4. The last two digits are not divisible by 4. Okay. So since the last two digits are not divisible by 4, the whole number is not divisible by 4. Okay. So what is the advantage of this use of divisibility? What are the learning outcomes you are going to learn? The first learning outcome is that it will save your time. It will help you to understand the concept of factors more easily. It will save your time. You can easily find out whether a number is divisible or not without dividing the number. So these are the uses of the divisibility rules. So let me check with some other number. Let me take 1248. I want to check whether this number is divisible by 4 or not. So again I will check the last two digits. 48 is the last two digits. The 1's place and the 10's place are the last two digits. So 48. So if you divide 48 with 4, 4 1's are 4, 0 and 8, 4 2's are 8. So we can see there is no remainder. Since there is no remainder, that means what? 48 is divisible by 4. So since 48 is divisible by 4, the whole number 1248 is divisible by 4. Clear? So that means the whole number is divisible by 4. Okay? So we have studied up to the divisibility rule of 4. Now next comes the divisibility test by 5. So the divisibility test for 5 is very easy. What is that? See your book, the 1's digit of the given number must be 0 or 5. The 1's digit, you will check the 1's digit now. Which is, let me write the number. 3, 2, 0. Okay. So, according to the divisibility rule of 5, we have to check the last digit again. If the last digit is 0 or 5, the whole number is divisible by 5. Okay, so we can see that there is a 0. So since there is a 0, the whole number will be divisible by 5. Check the last digit. Okay, let me take some other number now. 3 to 5. What is the last digit? The last digit is 5. So I said you, the divisibility test for 5 is, the last digit should be 0 or 5. So since this number is also having a 5, so it is also divisible by 5. If I take another number, 3 to 7, is the last digit 0 or 5? This time it's not a 0 nor a 5. So this 327 is not divisible by 5. It's not divisible by 5. Okay? So the test of divisibility of 5 is to check the last digit. If the last digit is 0 or 5, the whole number will be divisible by 5. So we have done the divisibility test for 5 also. So now we are going to check the divisibility test of 6. Okay. So again you see your books was written there, because you have to learn the, you have to remember the rules also. The number must be divisible by both 2 and 3. If the number is divisible by both 2 and 3, the whole number is divisible by 6. So you have to think of the divisibility test of 2 and 3. So what was the test for 2? The last digit should be 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. And what was the test of 3? The sum of the digits should be divisible by 3. So let me take a number. 432. Okay. So first I will check the divisibility of 2. And then I will check the divisibility of 3. If the number is divisible by both 2 and 3, then the whole number will be divisible by 6. So 4, 3 and 2. So what was the test for 2? The last digit should be 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. So what is the last digit? Your last digit is 2. So since the last digit is 2, then so that means this number is divisible by 2. Is divisible by 2. Okay, now we will check the divisibility by 3. So what was the test for 3? You have to add the digits. You have to find the sum of the digits. 4 plus 3, 7. 7 plus 2, 9. So 9 is also divisible by 3. So we can say it's divisible by 3. So since this number 432 is divisible by 2 also, it's divisible by 3 also. So that means the whole number 432 is divisible by 6. Okay, so how you are going to write? Since the number is divisible by both 2 and 3, so therefore 432 is divisible by 6. Okay, so this is the test for 6. Okay, so you can note it down also. Okay, so I'm just repeating it. So in the meantime, you keep on noting it down. We have taken a number 432. We want to check whether the number is divisible by 6 or not. So first we will check the divisibility by 2. So since the last digit is 2, so the number is divisible by 2. Now we will check the divisibility by 3. We will add the digits. We get a number 9. So since 9 is divisible by 3, so the whole number is divisible by 3. So we can see that 432 is divisible by 2 also. It's by 3 also. So since the number is divisible by both 2 and 3, so therefore we can say that 432 is divisible by 6. So this is the test for 6. So for 6 also it's done. I hope you have done it. Now we are going to do the divisibility of 9. So what is the test for 9? See your books again. The sum of the digits of the given number must be divisible by 9. So the divisibility of 9 is exactly same like the divisibility of 3. Again you have to find the sum of the digits. You have to add the digits and then you have to check whether the number is divisible by 9 or not. If the number is divisible by 9, the whole number will be divisible by 9. So let me take a number now to check whether the number is divisible by 9 or not. I am taking 824. I want to check for 9. So I said you it seemed like the divisibility of 3. So I will what I am going to do, I am going to add the digits again. 8 plus 2 plus 4. How much do you get? 8 plus 2 10. 10 plus 4 is 14. So does 14 comes in the table of 9? No, it doesn't come in the table of 9. So since 14 doesn't come in the table of 9, so 824 is not divisible by 9. So whenever you will be doing this type of sums, if you are asked to check, you have to write the reason also. In this case, what is the reason? Please note it down also at the same time in your classwork copies. We can write, since the number 14, okay, since the number 14 is not divisible by 9, therefore, 824 is not divisible by 9. So, this is the test for 9. Okay. So, we can also check this divisibility by some other number too. We have taken 824. You can test with some other numbers in your home also. Just give you, and you will see that it will be very helpful when you will do. When you want to test for bigger numbers, okay, you don't have to divide and then check whether a number is divisible or not. To study factors, you will be needing this. So let me take some other number now. Let me take 828. Again, let me add the digits. So 8 plus 2 is 10, 10 plus 8 is 18. So 18 comes in the table of 9. So since 18 comes in the table of 9, so what can we say? Since 18 is divisible by 9, therefore 828 is also divisible by 9. Okay, so this was the test for 9. Now we will test for 10. So for 10, it's very easy. What's written there? The ones digit of the given number must be 0. This time the ones digit of the given number will be 0. If it is 0, then the number is divisible by 10. So let me take a number 438. So what is the ones digit? The ones digit is 8. So it's not 0. So since it's not 0, it is not divisible by 10. That means the 1 digit should be 0 if a number has to be divided by 10. Let me take some other number 430. This time you can see it's a 0. So since it's a 0, the number is divisible by 10. Okay, so how will you write the reason? Since the 1's digit is 0, therefore 438 is divisible by 10. So you can note it down also. So I hope up to here you all are clear with the divisibility rules. So today in the home you will go through it properly. You will also revise it. Okay, you will revise the divisibility rules so that when we go for the next chapter, the factors, we don't find any difficulty. Okay. So I think with this we can end up for today's class. So your homework is to just read the divisibility rules properly so that in the next class of factors we can easily do the sums. Okay. So thank you everyone. Have a nice day. Bye bye.